My name is Kathy Swanson. I am the owner of Blushing Goddess Salon, and I am your next sexy hair artist. Today, Cindy is going to be our model, and on Cindy, I am going to use the Sexy Hair Color Safe Extra Volumizing Shampoo, as well as the conditioner. And then, because Cindy's looking for a style for her to go out tonight, I'm going to edge it up a little bit, something going from day into night as she just got off work. She's headed out with her girlfriends for dinner. I'm going to begin by using the Sexy Hair Blow Dry Volumizing Gel on her, followed with Soya One It All 22-in-1. Absolutely love this product, especially for Cindy, as she's an older woman with mature hair. This definitely gives her hair everything it needs, and it's going to work well with her. Then I'm going to follow it by some Altitude. Just want to put a little bit of that in to work with her cowlicks, give her some volume at her roots, and really just push that volume up. As you can tell, I'm a volume girl myself. And then I'm going to finish her off with three products. I'm going to finish off with the Spray and Play Harder, the Sexy Hair Control-Matic, just give her a little bit of PC edgy look to go with that nighttime look. And then my favorite new product, and that's the Big Shine. Just going to really push it over the top for her and give her that nice shine that she's going to need. So when she's out dancing underneath the lights, it'll shine and glisten and make her feel beautiful. I'm really excited to share this video with you today, and I look forward to telling you about my technique. As you see, I'm beginning to shampoo Cindy using the Color Safe Volumizing Shampoo and Conditioner by Sexy Hair. As you can see, I'm kind of just chatting her up, getting a vibe to find out, you know, what she's feeling and what she plans on doing for the night. I feel this is one of the most important steps when you're shampooing, only because you begin to create that bond with your client and you begin to really get to know them as a person, but it breaks that barrier of touch. Which always, you know, the power of touch is just absolutely amazing. So I like to take my time when I shampoo and get somebody nice and relaxed and get their hair straight, nice and clean. So I have a great beginning stage. So I'm definitely setting the tone for the entire service at this point. As you see, I begin spraying in the Soya One It All, and then I take the time to comb it through the hair and let that product really saturate into the hair strand. So that way, we're getting the best longevity out of the product. I educate my clients on this when they come in the salon to tell them, you know, put your products in and then maybe, you know, wrap your hair back up in your towel or your t-shirt, whatever it is you're using, and then let that product just kind of saturate in the hair. And while that's working, maybe apply your makeup or go get dressed or go feed the cat, but give it a couple minutes to really saturate into the hair strand so what I'm doing in the salon can be repeated at home. So you see me speaking with Cindy, I'm educating her on that and letting her know those are some good steps to follow. As you see, I'm beginning to blow dry Cindy's hair. I'm using kind of a freestyle method with blow drying just to really create that large volume that we like to get, and just kind of toss the hair around, check out the cowlicks, and really work with the hair's natural pattern in which it wants to lay, so that way I'm not forcing anything to go in the opposite direction, which I know some people like to do, but I feel like when we really work with the client's natural hair pattern, you get a better result. And truly, if you're a great stylist, you'll be able to work around those and yet still give your client what they want. So you see me, I'm just kind of freestyling using my paddle brush, and then I'll use my hands again in a moment just to create that volume and get the hair going in the direction I would like. And then again, I'm just kind of digging in a little further as I speak with Cindy about what she has planned for the evening, which will help me lay a great foundation for her hair. I'm taking the time to make sure I really get that hair dry behind the ears. You just see me moving her ears around to really get in there and get that dry. One of my biggest pet peeves is anytime I follow up behind somebody who's supposedly done a blowout, and I go in behind them and I find that there's still wet strands like behind the ears or around the ears because they were afraid of not getting that section. So I really wanted to make sure I got all that hair dry before we started. As you see, I'm starting to part Cindy off. Her hair is rather short, so I'm not parting her too far up. And she expressed to me that she tends to sweat a little bit more. So I wasn't doing a lot of flat ironing around the outside perimeter of her hair. And I'm also making sure to keep my blow dryer and my flat iron both at a lower temp, only because Cindy, as you can see, has been highlighted. And I want to make sure to not put too much heat on that hair and cause any breakage or cause any further damage. So I'm just kind of taking my time using my State of Michigan required endothermic comb to part her hair off and to use it to section when I'm flat ironing. As I'm flat ironing, you can see that I'm actually kind of just giving a little bit of a bend to the hair towards the ends a little bit, only to kind of give her a little curl under. She generally wears her hair pushed back from her face, and I really wanted to kind of push that forward and give her a little heightened volume towards the top. Cindy stands at about 5'1", and I really wanted to amp up her volume in the front just to create that long lean line, which will make her look a bit slimmer. So I wanted to create a higher height of volume at the top of her head versus on the sides, which is going to widen her even further. So you'll see that I'm not really creating much volume in the crown nor the back area. Most of the volume will come in just at the very top of her head. As I'm flat ironing her hair, you notice that I'm kind of bending the hair in the direction that I want the curl or the way I want the style of the hair to face, which is forward. You'll notice I do that a few times throughout her style, especially towards the front. So I really wanted, like I said, to push that hair towards the front and emphasize her and highlight her eyes. They are just absolutely gorgeous. So I wanted to highlight those. In addition, to kind of give her what I call like an organic look, I'm using my hands to separate her hair as I'm styling it versus using a paddle brush or a comb or a pick or anything else. It's kind of more of a natural look for her. She's kind of a no-fuss gal, so I just wanted to give her something that was true to her and how she usually does her hair, especially because she told me that she was probably going to sweat most of it out dancing tonight. So I decided to just keep things very organic and used my hands, and I'll use my comb a little bit here in a few minutes, but I did want to keep it as organic as possible. As I begin the finishing touches of Cindy's style, I back comb her hair a little bit and I push it, like I said, towards the front to highlight her great eyes and her cheekbones. And she has an amazing smile to go along with it. I wanted to give her something very close to what she usually wears on a daily basis, but again, just give it a little bit of a twist, something that she normally wouldn't do, which is pull it forward versus pushing it back. I think it highlights those eyes again, like I said, but I wanted to create that height for her at the top of her head. And you'll see me kind of go through and piece it apart with the tail end of my comb and also with my hands. As I'm finishing Cindy's look, you'll see me do a bit of back combing, like I said. And Cindy's overall look, her haircut is very quite wispy, so I wanted to just kind of edge that up a little bit to show her that she does have a fun side to this hairstyle and that there's more than one way to style it. And I didn't want to take her too far off path, as I said before. And I'm just piecing her out a little bit, and I make sure to finish her with the spray and play. And my last final finishing touch was the big shine, which will definitely make a difference in her hair. And I gave her a little bit extra of the hairspray only because I know her intentions were to go out dancing that night. So it would definitely keep her her volume in place while she dances the night away. I hope you've enjoyed my video. I look forward to hearing back from you guys with some feedback, whether you choose me or not. But I really look forward to working with Sexy Hair and becoming your guys' next Sexy Hair artist. Again, thank you for the opportunity. And Wayne Gretzky, I think, said it best when he stated that you miss 100% of the shots that you never take. I personally believe this, so whether I slam dunk it or not, I look forward to hearing back from you guys. Thank you so much for watching.